Hey, in this video, we will explore the question of what is Litecoin in crypto. Imagine that one day you really craved some chocolate. You didn't have any at home, so you decided to go to Target and buy some. After browsing the shelves for quite some time, you notice a stand full of Hershey's chocolates. While they were all from the same brand and based on the same principle, some of them were actual chocolate bars, while others were little chocolate candies known as kisses. You pick up the original Hershey's chocolate bar and some kisses. At that moment, it is fair to say that in your hands, you have two of the same chocolates, just one of them was in a different shape and perhaps a slightly different taste. While crypto projects can be compared to chocolates, the idea of altering the recipe, or in this case, code, to introduce a new blockchain network with certain improved capabilities is what ties this example and Litecoin together. Welcome to Crypto Finally Explained, the most crypto-friendly educational YouTube channel for actually learning crypto. Here, I finally explain crypto topics using simple animations, visual doodles, and real-life examples, so no matter if you're 5 or 75, you'll be able to understand it. In this video, we will look into what is the Litecoin crypto project. By exploring this network, we will also learn more about the Litecoin virtual currency and how does Litecoin work. Let's get right into it. If you're here, you have definitely heard about the largest cryptocurrency in terms of market capitalization, also known as digital gold, Bitcoin. While the project has witnessed huge success, it has some drawbacks. Back in 2011, the idea of altering some of Bitcoin's features and speeding up the transaction execution process did not let one man sleep. This man, named Charlie Lee, started analyzing and looking into Bitcoin's code in search of features that could be improved. However, at that time, the man treated his soon-to-be blockchain project as a side hustle because he was working as a software engineer at Google. For quite some time, Lee would generally write Bitcoin-based code during his free time away from Google. Eventually, after a few months of experimenting with the code, Lee introduced Litecoin on the cryptocurrency forum Bitcoin Talk. It took some time for Lee himself to understand the full potential of the blockchain network that he had just created. However, the seeds of interest in cryptocurrencies were already planted, as in 2013, the man left Google to work as the engineering director at the crypto exchange Coinbase. Finally, in 2017, Lee decided to put all of his eggs in Litecoin's basket and help the Litecoin Foundation boost the project's adoption. So, why did Lee create a new blockchain and what is the purpose of Litecoin? Well, according to Lee, he created the blockchain platform not to rival Bitcoin, but to instead serve as a tool for smaller, everyday transactions, calling it the silver to Bitcoin's gold, or simply, digital silver. Despite this, Litecoin saw daylight to solve three main issues linked to its brother, Bitcoin: scalability, speed, and centralization. Throughout this video, we will pay big attention to the differences and similarities between Bitcoin and Litecoin networks. Thus, if you're eager to know more about Bitcoin and how it operates, I encourage you to visit my channel and learn the specifics of the digital gold. Now, let's get back to Litecoin. It is believed that Litecoin opened the ground for a new category of cryptocurrencies known as altcoins. The definition is essentially used to describe all cryptocurrencies except industry leaders like Bitcoin and Ethereum. For example, cryptocurrencies like Tether, XRP, Solana, or Dogecoin fall into this category. So, what is Litecoin in crypto if you conclude everything that we just learned? In a nutshell, Litecoin is a blockchain network that was built using Bitcoin's code, and when compared to BTC, aims to offer increased scalability, transaction speed, and decentralization. At this point, you may be wondering, how does Litecoin work? Well, to start off, it is worth noting that as Litecoin was built using Bitcoin's code, it has several similarities with the network. Starting from the beginning, Litecoin, like Bitcoin, is an open-source blockchain that doesn't have a central authority that overlooks its operations. Due to this characteristic, someone can take Litecoin's code, as Lee did with Bitcoin, modify it, and launch a new blockchain network. At the same time, other developers can analyze the code and offer various improvements, which are later either approved or dismissed by the Decentralized Autonomous Organization, or DAO. Moving on, Litecoin operates using the same consensus mechanism as Bitcoin, proof of work. In this video, we will not delve too deeply into POW. However, if you want to learn more about this mechanism, I have a dedicated video comparing proof of work to proof of stake. As with every blockchain network that operates using proof-of-work, the network functionality relies on mining processes. With POW, miners use devices like personal computers or dedicated mining machines to solve complex cryptographic problems and verify blocks. For doing so, participants receive rewards, which are usually distributed in the form of network's native tokens. In this case, miners receive rewards in the form of Litecoin, or LTC. While both blockchain networks use the same consensus mechanism, they differ in the hash algorithm in which POW is applied. Think of it as going from destination A to destination B using public transport of your car. Traveling from one place to another with a car is a faster but much more complex task, as you need to have a driver's license and knowledge of how to control a vehicle. On the other hand, going to your destination via public transportation is more time-consuming, but it doesn't require much preparation to do so. You may wonder how what I just told you links to proof of work in terms of Bitcoin and Litecoin. For the next part of this video, bear with me because it's about to get a bit technical. From the beginning of time, Bitcoin used a secure hashing algorithm, or SHA-256, as its hash function and mining algorithm. On the other hand, when introducing Litecoin, Lee created a new algorithm called Script. So, why couldn't Lee just use Bitcoin's algorithm, right? Well, according to Lee, Script helps to solve almost all issues he identified in the Bitcoin network. The developer believed that Script would help with the centralization issue as Bitcoin was mainly mined using application-specific integrated circuit, or ASIC-based miners. These miners are quite expensive and are generally used by big corporations, thus making the circle of Bitcoin miners quite centralized. On the other hand, Lee and the Litecoin development team hoped that by using Script, the network would become more accessible. It is because Script favored central processing unit, CPU, and graphic processing unit, GPU, based miners. These miners were essentially crypto enthusiasts who used regular computers, which in turn meant that almost anyone could mine Litecoin. In particular, the Script algorithm was more memory intensive, making it completely unsuitable for ASIC-based miners. To help you understand the topic, let's remember the days of downloading music to your smartphones. Compared to current phones, the 2013 version of such smartphones was arguably not as smart. Back in the day, you would need a USB or other type of wire to connect your phone and laptop to upload the music into it. However, nowadays, you use apps like Spotify that give you a full selection of songs, removing any interaction with wires or even computers, thus making the process of downloading and listening to music more accessible. But how does Script help Litecoin? Well, the use of Script allowed Litecoin to boost its transaction speeds and offer lower network fees, as it's less energy consuming than SHA-256. Litecoin enjoys a block time of 2.5 minutes, which allows it to process over 50 transactions per second. Impressive, right? In terms of development, due to its similarities to the Bitcoin network, Litecoin is often used as a testnet for features intended for the digital gold network. It is worth noting that Litecoin was the first blockchain to implement Lightning Network on its platform. If you're not familiar, Lightning Network is a layer 2 solution used to facilitate fast and cheap Bitcoin transactions. As we now know all the details about how Litecoin works, it's time to look at its tokenomics and search for an answer to the question, what is the Litecoin cryptocurrency? The Litecoin virtual currency holds the same name as the whole network, with a ticker LTC. What is interesting about the launch of LTC is that it wasn't pre-mined and distributed to the development team or set aside for future projects. Instead, its developer, Lee, essentially woke up one morning and said, "You can now mint Litecoin." However, through its existence, there could be only 84 million Litecoin tokens on the network. Once the cap is reached, new coins will not be added to the circulation. Thus, miners will be paid using transaction fees. Litecoin's similarities with Bitcoin stretch to halvings as well. Halvings are events that slash block production rewards in half. This feature helps to retain the coin's value as its supply reduces over time. In particular, a halving event takes place every 840,000 transactions, or around every 4 years or so. When Litecoin first saw the daylight, it rewarded miners with 50 LTC for adding a new block to the blockchain. The first halving event took place in 2015, which reduced the rewards to 25 LTC. The fourth and most recent halving event happened in August of 2023, which reduced the rewards to 6.25 LTC. So, what is Litecoin used for? As I mentioned before, Litecoin was mainly developed to serve as sound money for day-to-day transactions. Therefore, Litecoin's development team worked hard to increase transaction speeds and offer lower fees, making it a great choice for paying for groceries or gas. In terms of its applicability, LTC has already found its way into mainstream adoption. In 2019, Litecoin was declared the official cryptocurrency of the American football team, the Miami Dolphins. The title allows local football enthusiasts to buy tickets to their games using LTC. Cool, right? It is worth noting that Litecoin is positioned among the top 20 cryptocurrencies in terms of market capitalization. If you're wondering where to buy LTC, the answer is simple. As with many other cryptocurrencies, Litecoin can be purchased on major crypto exchanges like Coinbase and Binance. Throughout this video, I often mention that Litecoin has several similarities to Bitcoin. But what is the difference between Litecoin and Bitcoin? Let's find out. If we look at it from the perspective of what kind of problems Lee wanted to fix with the launch of Litecoin, the differences become quite clear. If you forgot, Lee wanted to increase speed, scalability, and make the network more decentralized than Bitcoin. As discussed earlier, Bitcoin and Litecoin's main differences lie in their POW mining algorithms. While Bitcoin uses SHA-256, Litecoin employs the Script algorithm. The switch to Script allowed Lee to make Litecoin more decentralized and is significantly faster. So, how fast is Litecoin compared to Bitcoin? Well, significantly faster. As I mentioned before, blocks on the network are generated every 2.5 minutes, whilst on Bitcoin, they are generated every 10 minutes. That is 4 times faster. This means that while the Bitcoin network processes 6 transactions per second, Litecoin can handle 54 transactions. At the same time, transaction fees are also significantly lower. While the users of the Bitcoin network, on average, have to spend a few dollars to cover transaction fees, Litecoin users usually pay no more than a few pennies. Another difference between Bitcoin and Litecoin lies in the supply cap of crypto tokens. Bitcoin has a maximum supply of 21 million tokens. On the other hand, Litecoin has 4 times as much, 84 million. We have now reached the end of the video. I hope that the path to understanding what is Litecoin in crypto was quite smooth. Before we go, let's recap what we now know about Litecoin's silver coin, as well as how Litecoin works. In the crypto world, Litecoin can be considered Bitcoin's brother or the silver to Bitcoin's gold. While taking the main functionalities from arguably the biggest network in the crypto ecosystem, Litecoin strove to improve its scalability, speed, and decentralization. By doing so, Litecoin brought new wins to the crypto ecosystem, introducing a new form of sound money, suitable for day-to-day transactions. What do you think about Litecoin? Can we call it a better or more successful version of Bitcoin? Be sure to leave a comment below and let's discuss. Finally, if you found this video helpful, be sure to press those like and subscribe buttons. And as always, I'll see you in the next video.